The term poltergeist comes from the combination of two old German words that mean striking and spirit, and is used to refer to phenomena of destructive ghosts who repeatedly concentrate all their power against a place or some people. The first records of this phenomenon date back to the year 1000, in Germany, but formerly, its causes were unknown and the Catholic Church associated it with a diabolical manifestation. Furthermore, they asserted that the poltergeist was a special and very powerful demon who nourished on the souls of the living. The particular rage with which they provoke their attacks is the product of their frustration and denial of death, because these spirits refuse to have died, and, for that reason, they begin to break into houses that, according to experts, are vulnerable nests of anger. This means that it is the victims who, unconsciously, attract the evil spirits. The poltergeist wreak havoc especially in England, and these are one of the few paranormal phenomena that can be analyzed for the duration they have, since they usually last a long time. In 1977, near Enfield, an English city, lived the Harper family, formed by the divorced mother and her four children, Rose, Janet, Peter, and Jimmy. On the evening of August 30th, the beds of Peter and Janet, who slept in the same room, began to move by themselves. Tables that weighed heavily moved from side to side. The neighbors also claimed to have heard strong blows, as if it were some excavating machine. The police arrived at the place, but they could not do much, and several times, even they were also victims of the creepy visitors of beyond. The amazement of the community was such that the press also went to the site of events, and indeed, the place was in chaos, things flying around the house, strange noises, roars, among other paranormal phenomena. Such was the astonishment of the spectators, that they contacted the Society of Psychical Research, whom, with the help of a renowned medium, managed to appease the mysterious presence for several weeks, since it had possessed the youngest daughter of the family and her mother. But months later, the attacks became more and more violent, and it wasn't small objects or toys which flew around the house, but the furniture, closets, and beds were abruptly thrown into the air. This time, the attack was accompanied by enormous human silhouettes, which appeared frequently. The only way to end this horrific visit was discovered and used by a Dutch medium called Grinnelling Meiling, who made an intervention on the astral plane, or astral world. And finally, in April 1979, the family's nightmare ended. Of course, there are skeptics of the subject, such as the American magician James the Amazing Randi, who sees, in the place of events, nothing but hallucinations or mystifications. Randi starts from the principle that every manifestation called paranormal is false from the moment in which it begins to grow massively.